Today, we're going to be learning how to navigate in Blender as the first installment in my new series for absolute Blender beginners to get them familiar with 3D modeling in Blender whilst building a good fundamental knowledge so you actually know what you're doing when you're modeling in Blender. The first installments in this series may be a little bit basic for a lot of my viewers, but I promise that later on in the course, we will go over some more interesting tips and stuff. So make sure to stick around if you're interested in that as well. As I mentioned, today we're going to be learning about basic navigation. So to start off, if we want to move around our scene, we can just hold down the middle mouse button by pressing it with your finger and then moving your mouse. You can see, this way, I can move around the viewport. If you don't have a middle mouse button, you can left click and hold this gizmo here. And as you move your mouse whilst left clicking and holding, you can see I'm rotating around the 3D viewport. That's not the only way to move though. We can also hold down the shift key and then use the middle mouse button. And you can see this is going to allow me to what we call pan, which pretty much allows us to move left and right and up and down without any rotational movement. Again, if you can't use your middle mouse button, you can left click this hand icon and it's going to do the exact same thing. So I just left click and hold and move my mouse and it's going to move like that. Next up, if you want to zoom in or zoom out, you can just scroll the wheel on your mouse and that's just going to allow us to zoom in and out. If you don't have a scroll wheel, you can use this zoom icon here by just left clicking and holding it on the right here, and that's going to allow us to zoom in and out. If you can't see any of these icons, do keep in mind that this button here might be off. To turn it back on, we just need to make sure this show gizmo button is blue. At the bottom here, we have an option called switch the current view from perspective to orthographic, and when I left click that, you can see everything goes a little bit more distorted. I left click it again to go back to perspective, and I'm going to press shift A, and this is going to allow us to add objects into our scene. So you can see it's add, so you can think of it as shift A for add. Then under mesh, I'm going to choose cube. You might have one of these in your scene by default. Again, if I want to navigate, I can just use my middle mouse button like this. But when I change this mode to orthographic, you can see it will make our object look a little bit different. Another button you might notice here is this camera button. And this is only applicable if you have a camera in your scene. When I left click this button, you'll see nothing will happen because I don't have a camera in my scene. Speaking of which, how can we tell what we have in our scene? If you come up to the top right hand corner, you can see we have this thing called the outliner. And it shows all the different types of objects, elements we have in our scene. Do keep in mind some of them may be hidden by this little arrow button, in which case you can left click it to open up more information. You may have a camera already in your scene, but since I don't, I'm going to open the add menu again by pressing shift and then A, and then this time I'm going to choose camera by left clicking. And that has added a camera into our scene. Something you'll notice as well, if I press G, which is the grab key, and move it, is everything is added into the center of the world. But it's not actually determined by the center of the world, it's determined by this 3D cursor. If you want to learn about moving this 3D cursor, it's a little bit more advanced, so I'm going to be putting this into the sixth installment in this series. But it is a video I already have if you want to check it out. Now when I press this camera button, you can see it's going to go into my camera view. You'll also notice that in my outliner here, we have our camera and our cube. In the next video, we're going to be learning about how we can move, scale, and rotate our objects in Blender. If you want to be ready for the next videos in this series, make sure to check out the playlist here, as the videos may already be out while you're watching this video. Apart from that, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.